Hey guys, so today's video is a haul slash review type of video. I tweeted about a week ago that the studio line from e.l.f. was 50% off on their website, so mama went a little crazy. There have been so many things from e.l.f. that I really wanted to try, but I didn't feel like ordering online and paying for shipping and yada yada yada. So when I saw that the studio line was 50% off, I was like, here's your chance. Which is awesome because the studio line is the line I prefer from e.l.f. So yeah, let's just hop in. Oh, by the way, everything on my face today is e.l.f. I used all these products, well not all these products on my face today, but all the products that are on my face are using these products. So that's why it's kind of like a review as well, since I did use them on my face today. So it's kind of like a first impressions kind of review. I'm gonna be showing you everything and swatching everything and telling you my thoughts on everything. So yeah. The only thing that isn't e.l.f. on my face is my mascara and my under eye concealer. But everything else is e.l.f. So I picked up three brushes from e.l.f. The first thing I picked up is the Kabuki Face Brush. I have been wanting to try this forever. This retails for $6, but since it was 50% off, I got it for $3. And I did use this today to set my foundation, and I put everything back into the packaging so you could see what it looks like in the packaging, you know? But I did use this today to set my foundation with my MSF Natural. Oh yeah, that's another thing that's not e.l.f. But just those three things. And I love this thing. Like, I don't know what took me so long to buy it. This just sets my foundation so amazingly. Like, it's so soft. It's like, it's like a bunny's little butt. Like a little bunny butt or tail. Not butt. So yeah, I really, really love this. I definitely recommend it. Even if you get it for the full $6, it's amazing. I would pay more than $6 for this because I love it. I also got this pointed foundation brush. I had never seen this brush before at Target or on the website, but my friend ordered some stuff off of the website too, and this is one of the things she got. So I saw it the other day and I was like, oh my god, I want it. It reminds me a lot of the Sigma, like the Sigmax collection, the pointed one that a lot of people like to use to blend out their concealer. It's not a dupe. The bristles feel completely different, but it is a similar shape. That's what I'm trying to say. And I used it today to blend out my under eye concealer, and I really, really like it. I think it blends out your under eye concealer pretty nicely, actually. Like, I really liked it. So if you've been wanting to get that Sigma one, but you don't want to pay the money or anything, just try this out. It's $3. Like I said, it's not a dupe for that one, but I mean, it gets the job done. I really like it. And then the brush that I was mostly surprised with was this complexion brush. I know they sell this one at Target, but I had never picked it up, and I really, really like this brush. I used it today to put on my my bronzer. I used it all over my face, and I really like it because I think it's perfect to contour your face, to get a natural contour, since it goes, since it's like, you know, tapered like this. You just get right up in there and it blends out your bronzer beautifully. I used it today, like I said, and I'm so impressed with this brush. It blended out my bronzer like heavenly. Really like it. I got all of their baked highlighters. There's only three of them. This is what they look like. This one is called Blush Gems, and it is just a kind of like bronzy type of highlight. There is a little bit of pink to it, but not that much. It's a really, really pretty highlight. I really like this one. This one is Blush Gems. This one is called Pink Diamonds, and it is exactly that. It's very, very, very pink, as you can see. I'm not into pink highlights at all, so I don't know how I'm going to be using this one. But when I do swatch it on my hand, it is a beautiful pink. So maybe I'll put this like on top of like a matte pink blush to just give it a little bit of a glow. But this one's really pretty. And then this one is my favorite one. This one is Moonlight Pearls, and it is just an ivory kind of highlight. Reminds me a lot of the Balm's Mary Luminizer. It has that type of like light golden ivory color. It is absolutely beautiful. I'm obsessed with it. And I think that these baked highlighters are great, especially for the price, because there is not a lot of glitter in them. I don't know how to explain it. Once you rub your finger over the top, you're like, oh, this isn't really that pigmented. But when you know, swatch it on your hand, it gives a beautiful sheen, and that's what I love about it, because I hate glitter. I like highlights that give off a sheen, like that wet look, and this definitely does that. Also, keep in mind that you can use this wet if you want a crazy, crazy, like I'm talking crazy intense highlight. Wet them and it'll be very intense. So yeah, I give these a thumbs up. I got the e.l.f. Daily Moisture Stick, and the only reason I got this is because I've heard Emily Noel rave about this for a while now, and it is just like pretty much exactly what it is. It's a moisture stick, and it says it's enriched with antioxidants and anti-aging ingredients: grape, cocoa, shake, avocado, macadamia, aloe, and chamomile. Chamomile is my life. I love anything that has chamomile in it. So I decided to pick it up. It just looks like this, and then pop this little sucker off, and it looks like a giant chapstick, basically. And I use this underneath my makeup today in certain areas where foundation tends to cake me up a little bit. So I used it around my nose and in between my forehead and a little bit underneath my eyes, and I actually really like it. It has a cooling effect, and it's really nice. So yeah, I mean, it's cool. I have to see what other things I could possibly use this for, but so far, I mean, it's cool. I got the e.l.f. Makeup Remover Cleansing Cloths. I've never tried these before. Let me smell them. Oh, they don't smell bad. I hope they don't burn my eyes, because that is my biggest pet peeve with makeup removers. So, I mean, that's that. The next thing I got was the thing that I was most excited for out of everything that I got, and it is the e.l.f. Acne Fighting Foundation. Flawless coverage formula that helps prevent and treat acne. I don't know about that. I'm always extremely skeptical when it comes to foundations that claim to improve acne. I don't know. But yeah, I got mine in the color buff, and this is what it looks like. The packaging reminds me a lot of Clinique packaging and the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Plus. It reminds me a lot of that, but I honestly think that this is a dupe, or at least they're trying to imitate a Clinique foundation that's in this exact bottle, and it's also an acne fighting foundation from Clinique. I'm not sure. I could be completely wrong. But yeah, the color match is pretty good. I winged it on the website. I was like, oh, okay, I guess I'm buff. And it's pretty good. It's just like a hair too dark for me. But now going into spring and summer, it's probably gonna be like an exact match. I am wearing this on my face right now, actually. The only thing that I'm like, ugh, about is the fact that it has witch hazel in it, which is great for oily skin, but it's not great for people with dry skin like me. It didn't cake up my face all that much, actually. I did use this underneath it, and I didn't really get cakiness at all. I used a very thin layer all over my face, and it didn't really cake up. I don't know. The coverage is really good. Like, it has a lot of coverage. I literally used just a thin layer and buffed it all over my face, and it gave me like pretty good coverage. I think this would be amazing for oily skin or normal skin. For me, it worked pretty well, and I have dry skin, but I did have moisturizer on before. So if you want to buy this and you have dry skin, I would just advise you to moisturize. If you want me to go more in depth with this foundation, like a whole foundation review and me wear it throughout the day and stuff like that, let me know in the comments below and I'll do a whole review on that. I picked up the HD Under Eye Setting Powder. This is what I used to set my under eye concealer today, and it's good. The only thing I don't like is the glitter. There's glitter in this product. Why is there glitter in this product? Why? There's like literally specks of glitter all over this thing, and it sucks because it feels really, really nice. I just wish that it didn't have the glitters in it. So what I did is that I set my under eye concealer, and I kind of got another brush and kind of brushed the glitters away, and it seemed to work. I don't really see much glitter underneath my eyes at all after I did that, so I'm gonna continue to use it because I think it's pretty good. I haven't used it for a full day, so I can't really tell you if it's amazing, but it's pretty good. Just e.l.f., come on, take the glitter out of this thing. Come on. I got 5 of their baked eyeshadows, and I gotta say, I am obsessed with these. I am loving them. They are really, really good. I got 5. They're good. I have this one in Passion Purple, which is a really, really nice, intense, deep purple. It is absolutely beautiful. These are not pigmented on their own, as you can see, like once I rub my finger on it. So I definitely recommend using them wet. When you use them wet, they are amazing. It gives off such a beautiful sheen, a beautiful glow. I absolutely love them. I think they're worth the $3. They're really inexpensive and they're worth it. So once you use them wet, either a little bit of water, a little bit of Fix Plus, they will just glow on your eyes. I definitely recommend them. They're amazing. I got that one. This one is in the color Pixie. It's a beautiful goldeny pink. And this one is absolutely beautiful too. Once you wet it, you see the gold really shine through the pink. I don't know how to explain it, but I really, really love this one. It's like a pretty rose gold. I also got this one, which is probably my favorite one. This one is in the shade Toasted. I've seen this one a bunch of times at Target, so literally run out to Target right now and go buy this because it is beautiful. But out of all the ones, this one actually is very pigmented without wetting it. As you can see, it's like super pigmented and I didn't have to wet it. This is my favorite one. It looks amazing dry and even more amazing wet. I also got Chocolate Dreams, which is a beautiful deep chocolatey color. Just looks like this. It's so nice when you wet it, but it also is just like Toasted in the sense that you get pigment when it's dry. So it's super pigmented too. I love it wet or dry, amazing. I definitely recommend, I just dropped Toasted, but I definitely recommend this one in Toasted. And then the last one I got is called Bronze Beauty. This one is right up my alley. It is just an intense gold eyeshadow. And you guys know how I feel about, I actually recommend this one too. This one, Toasted, and Chocolate Dreams. Amazing. This one is Bronze Beauty. I don't know if I said that already, but it is also pretty pigmented once you swatch it. Not as pigmented as the other two, but wet, this looks heavenly. Toasted, Chocolate Dreams, and Bronze Beauty are what I'm wearing on my eyes right now, and nothing else. I have Toasted all over my lid, Chocolate Dreams in the outer V and in my crease, and then I have this beautiful gold one underneath my lash line. I'm just obsessed with these. I got one of their matte lip colors. This is in the color Coral. It's what's on my lips right now. These are really, really good. I'm gonna go and pick up some more because I only bought one of them, but I'm really impressed. The only thing I will say is that you really need to exfoliate your lips before you put this on and use a base, like a chapstick or an EOS lip balm or something, because this kind of sinks into your fine lines a lot. I was like, ugh. So I had to go and put chapstick underneath and exfoliate my lips a little bit. But once I did that, it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful color. So I recommend them just exfoliate, girl. I picked up one of their baked blushes in Peachy Cheeky. And it's just a really, really light shimmery, not shimmery, yeah, shimmery peach color. It's too shimmery for me to wear as like a blush and then a highlight. This is what's on my cheeks right now as a highlight because there's not too much pigment coming off of this thing. I don't know. I mean, it is pigmented, but honestly, it's not too pigmented for me to wear it as a blush personally. So I did use this as a highlight, and it does give a really pretty peachy glow. So it kind of doubles up as both. A blush and a highlight. More highlight, but you can get away with it using as a blush. And I think this would look amazing in the summer. I'm just like, I can't wait for the spring and summer because I think this would look fabulous. I picked up the eyebrow kit from e.l.f. and all the other ones were sold out except medium. And yeah, it's too dark for me. It's what's on my eyebrows right now. I'm gonna go do my eyebrows tomorrow, so they're looking a little wonky. But yeah, this is what it looks like. This is actually an amazing product. I'm so impressed. It comes with a wax and a powder. Again, this is way too dark for me, as you can see, like, what? Way too dark. The wax really keeps my eyebrows in place, and the powder is just so easy to blend. It's amazing. Definitely check this out. It's worth every penny, and it's $3. I got a cream eyeliner in the shade Copper. I really like the e.l.f. cream liners. I used to use the black one all the time back in the Dizzle, but I found that the Maybelline one is a lot better, so I switched over. But I got this one in Copper just because I think it's a beautiful bronze chocolatey color. It's what I used as a primer for my eyes today. I used it as a base and it was amazing. The eyeshadows looked great on top of it. And I also used it on my waterline and a little bit on the top. And I think it's beautiful. I think I'm going to get some more colors because they have really nice colors. I'm going to use them as primers because it works really well and it doesn't crease on me personally. So I'm impressed. And then the last three things I picked up are the blush and bronzer duos. I have the original one that is now called St. Lucia. This is my original one and I absolutely love this. I use it all the time. So I figured I would get the other ones that they have. I picked up this one. This is in the color Antigua. And it's just like a darker bronzer with a really, really bright pink blush. I really, really love this. I haven't used this one yet, but I've swatched it and it's like really intense. I don't know. I think that this would be amazing in the summer, or for deeper skin tones, I think that you would really like this one because it's intense. And then I picked up Turks and Caicos, which is a lighter bronzer and blush. Well, the bronzer is not light at all, actually. Is it darker than Antigua? Let's see. Oh, yeah. I think that Turks and Caicos has a darker bronzer. An even darker bronzer. Okay. I think so. Or they're the same. I don't know. But this is what it looks like. I think it's absolutely beautiful. This is the bronzer I'm using on my face today. And if you use a light hand, then I think that people with fair skin tone can use it. You just have to use a very light hand because that's pigmented. It's like pigmented. And I love the blush in this one. It is a very bronzy blush. And then I got the contouring blush and bronzing cream. This is also in the color Saint Lucia, just like the original one, only it's a cream. And I am so impressed with this. So impressed with this. My friend has it, and I was playing with it at her house, and I was super impressed with the bronzer. It's not like too orangey. And it's really, really pigmented, and it's pretty easy to blend. I really liked it. I haven't used the blush, so I don't know if it's good or not. I actually don't own any cream blushes, so this is gonna be fun. I do want to mention, though, that this bronzer applies amazingly well with the e.l.f. Small Stipple Brush. I bought this a couple weeks ago, and you just dip it into your bronzer and apply it right to the contours of your cheek, and it blends out beautifully, and it blends it out beautifully up here. I recommend this brush 100%. Okay guys, so that is everything I got off the e.l.f. website. I know it's a lot, but everything in the studio line was 50% off, so I jumped at the opportunity. I would say I'm pretty impressed with everything I got. There are a couple little things here and there that I wasn't too impressed with, but overall I think it was a... Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you have any questions, leave them down below. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. I would really like that. And yeah, I think that's it. I'll see you in my next video, guys. Bye. Under eye setting powder from e.l.f. Obviously, all this stuff is from e.l.f. And I got the cream bronze. And then I got the... I like highlights that give off... I like highlights. Highlights. Gape. 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 Grape. All over my face and buffed it out. Excuse me, that's my text message sound. Who is texting me so much? Good lord, how messy. This is Pink Passion. Pink Diamonds. Pink Passion. Oh, yeah. It reminds me a lot of the makeup for...